Hi, my name is Brian Bruckmoser, and I'm a systems engineer for Belden's Enterprise Division. In this video today, we will walk through the steps of terminating a KeyConnect 10GX jack. Before we go through those termination steps, I want to highlight some of the benefits of the 10GX jack that might be important to you. This jack looks a little different because it is. It has the matrix IDC technology. You'll notice that the IDC connectors are rotated 90 degrees out of phase, eliminating the effect of alien crosstalk between jacks. Second, we have the X-bar. The X-bar technology is an installation aid that controls the position of every pair before termination and reduces the variability between installers. Third, inside the jack is the flex point PCB. This is not a rigid circuit board with solder points that are a potential point of failure. The flexible board compensates at the connection point to achieve guaranteed crosstalk performance to 625 megahertz. In order to maximize the value and capitalize on all of the benefits of the 10GX jack, it must be terminated properly. So let's go through those steps now. Our first step is going to be to prepare the cable. I'm going to take the Belden 1797B. I'm going to take off a couple of inches of the jacket, spin it around the jacket just once, crack the cable, and take it off. You'll notice that there's a ripcord. We're going to use that ripcord to tear down the jacket just a little bit further. The reason we want to do that is we've just taken a razor blade and spun it around, and there's a chance we nick the conductors. So we want to make sure that we get down past that so that doesn't affect our termination. Next step we're going to do is clean up this outside portion of the jacket. Once we've cleaned up the outside portion of the jacket, we're going to prepare the wires by putting them in the proper order. We're going to do a 568B termination today. So the proper order is going to be the blue, the brown, the green, and the orange. The X-bar has spikes or points on one side and is flat on the other side. The points need to go towards the jacket cable, and the flat side needs to go towards the outside so that you can snap it into the jack in a later step. So there are two full channels and two partial channels. The two full channels in the center of the X-bar is where the brown and the green go. Slides in. Slide it close to the jack. Now you'll notice that there's a slot on one side of these closed channels, and you'll just take the wire and move it towards that slot. Do the two center ones first, and then you know, because they alternate, that the green is going this way, the orange must go this way, and the blue must go this way. So we've got brown and orange on one side and blue and green on the other side. The next step will be to snap the X-bar into the modular jack. So we'll orient the blue, blue, white here to the blue, blue, white on the jack and snap it into place. Next step will be to seat the wires into the IDCs. You'll notice there's a little crown in the middle. You can use that crown to help split the pairs a little bit. Brown conductors always go. The solid conductors always go to the outside, and the striped always go to the inside. Once you have them partially seated, you'll snap the modular jack into the termination station. Use the keystone style opening. Picture here shows the latching device pointing down, so we'll orient the jack that way. Slide it into the termination station and move it to the outside. Now we have a nice surface to perform the rest of our punch down. Once you're finished inserting the conductors into the jack, you'll just move the jack back towards the center of the termination station and remove it. You'll notice that the conductors are fully seated in the IDCs, and they have a nice, clean cut. Well, those are the termination steps to properly terminate a 10GX jack. Call 1-800-BELDEN-1 or contact your local sales representative. Thank you for choosing Belden.